Hello, my name is Brianna Hood, and today I'll be doing my speech about climate change. In today's day and age, we as humans create a lot of trash in many ways that we don't even realize. Earth's climate has changed throughout history. Just in the last 650,000 years, there have been 7 cycles of glacial advance and retreat, with the abrupt end of the last ice age about 11,700 years ago, marking the beginning of the modern climate era and of human civilization. Most of these climate changes are attributed to very small variations in the Earth's orbit that can change the amount of solar energy our planet receives. According to climatenasa.gov, Earth orbiting satellites and other technological advances have been enabled scientists to see the big picture, collecting many different types of information about our planet and its climate on a global scale. This body of data collected over many years reveals the signals of a changing climate. The heat-trapping nature of carbon dioxide and other gases was demonstrated in the mid-19th century. Their ability to affect the transfer or infrared energy through the atmosphere is the scientific basis of many instruments flown at NASA. There is no question that the increased levels of greenhouse gases must cause the Earth to warm in response. Over the next several minutes, I'll explain why we should take all measures we can to stop climate change by using renewable resources. Climate change refers to long-term shifts in temperatures and weather patterns. These shifts may be natural, but since the 1800s, human activities have been the main driver of climate change, primarily due to burning fossil fuels like coal, oil, and gas, which produces heat-trapping gases. In a crisis, everyone needs to pull together. Climate change is no exception. The planet's carbon budget is finite and is running out. Some people say green companies are the answer. They're right. The world does need more green companies to help help meet Paris goals. But that's not enough. For the world to meet Paris goals, we need to go where the emissions are. That means transforming energy, transport, and industry, the sectors accounting for approximately 70% of global emissions. That's where the greening companies come in. According to BP.com, greening companies are companies that are not lowering carbon today, but are serious about getting there. They are companies that have credible plans to transform and become greener. Companies that know the world wants and needs it to change, that recognize the opportunity and are working there to deliver it. Companies like Equinor, Enel, Scottish Power are transferring to meet the demands for lower carbon energy. Backing these companies that are transitioning is every bit as important as backing green companies. According to the New York Times, here are some other options to help for climate change. One is renewable energy. Scientists agree that to avoid the most catastrophic events of climate change, countries must immediately move away from dirty energy sources like coal, oil, and gas, and turn to renewable resources like wind, solar, or nuclear power. The second one is refrigerants. It's not the most exciting solution to climate change, but is one of the most effective. Like air conditioners, more efficient, could eliminate a full degree Celsius of warming by 2100. The third one is transportation. Across the globe, governments are focused on limiting one of the world's biggest sources of pollution, gasoline-powered cars. So you can use like a Tesla or cars that you have to charge that don't use gas. The fourth one is methane emissions. You hear a lot about the need to reduce carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, but what about its dangerous cousin methane? And then the fifth one is agriculture. Efforts to limit global warming often target fossil fuels, but cutting greenhouse gases from the food production is urgent too, research says. The sixth one is nature conservation. Scientists agree that reversing biodiversity loss is a crucial way of slowing climate change. And the seventh one is carbon capture. Eliminating emissions alone may not be enough to avoid some of the worst effects of climate change. So some companies are investing in technology that sucks carbon dioxide out of the air. So basically, if you do things like get solar panels on top of your house, even opening the fridge for like less time so you can, that's just to save money as well. And buying, you know, hybrid cars if you're not fully sold on fully, like, Teslas. You can get hybrid cars and you can still use both. But in conclusion, people should always try their best to take care of the planet, because we only get one planet and that's all we get. So we should treat it better for people in the future, for our kids and for our grandkids and things like that. So yes, thank you for listening to my presentation, and I hope that you have a wonderful day.